Right, so I recently found out that many of you are not aware of this concept, that is steric inhibition of protonation. Now this is a very fundamental concept, and generally the questions are asked from IIT JEE, okay, on this particular concept. Generally questions are asked in IIT JEE entrance exam, but it is also very relevant to CSIR NET exams, JAM, KATE, okay, because there is something really different happening in this case. And we'll look what exactly is steric inhibition of protonation. You might be getting some idea, but the aim of this video is to first of all give you an introduction to the concept, and then tell you as to how the questions can be framed from this particular concept. Okay, so let's for example take dimethyl aniline. Okay. We'll take dimethyl aniline, and along with that we'll take aniline. Now if you look at this, and if I say that I'm adding a acid, basically H+, so the protonation, which one will more likely undergo protonation? Or the other way to ask is, which of these nitrogens is more basic? Now, if some person who is not aware of this particular concept, if he looks at both the molecules, he will say that this one over here, dimethylaniline, is more basic, and it will undergo protonation faster. Why? Because this methyl group has plus I effect. Right, this methyl group has plus I effect, which is at the ortho position. Similarly, this methyl group also has a plus I effect, which is at the ortho position. So there are two methyl groups, and both have plus I effect. Because of this plus I effect, what is going to happen is the electron density on this nitrogen. Okay, nitrogen has lone pair of electrons, and if a plus I effect is taking place because of the two methyl groups at the ortho position, the electron density on this nitrogen is going to increase. Right, the electron density on this nitrogen is going to increase. So what is happening? It will appear to be more basic, but in reality, this is more basic. So the protonation for this aniline will be faster than dimethyl aniline. Okay, dimethyl aniline. And what is the reason for that? So the reason is this concept, steric inhibition of protonation. This is why this concept explains why aniline is more basic than dimethyl aniline, even though the two methyl groups have plus I effect, which are increasing the electron density on the nitrogen. Now, we'll have to look at the conjugate acid. Okay, the conjugate acid. Now, if I draw the conjugate acid is nothing but after the protonation, what is generated. We have three hydrogens, okay. And now I'll draw the amine. Now, if you look at the structure, you'll automatically see something. What will you see? You are going to see the repulsions taking place between the methyl group at the ortho position and the hydrogens of the nitrogen. Now, because of this repulsion, the conjugate acid is very unstable. Right? The conjugate acid is very, very unstable. Even though the electron density on nitrogen is very high, and it will appear that this dimethyl aniline will undergo protonation faster, or it is more likely to undergo protonation than aniline, but because of this conjugate acid that is formed once the protonation takes place, this conjugate acid is very unstable because of the steric repulsions between this methyl group and the hydrogens, and the hydrogens of this methyl group and the nitrogen. Similarly, if we only had one methyl group also, even in that case, the NH2 will be faster. Even if we had one NH but once history also, even then also the anion will be more basic. Because even if there was one methyl group, even then the steric repulsion would have taken place, which would have made the conjugate acid unstable. Okay, so this is the whole concept of steric inhibition of protonation. Okay, and one more thing that I wanted to point out was, there's one more way that they can frame this question. Either they can ask you which one of them is more basic, so then you can immediately say that this one aniline is more basic than dimethyl aniline or methyl aniline also, orthomethyl aniline. Okay. But the other way that the question can be framed is, this over here is known as an anilinium ion. Okay, this is known as an anilinium ion. Okay, similarly, this could be called as a dimethyl anilinium ion. Dimethyl and anilinium ion. Now, the other way that we can ask you the question is, out of these two, which one has a higher pKa, or arrange them in order of pKa value. So what will they say? Arrange the following in the order of pKa value. And they'll give you dimethyl anilinium ion, and they'll give you anilinium ion. Now again, it will appear that because of the two methyl groups, if you're not aware of this concept, it will appear to you that the methyl groups, since this nitrogen is electron deficient, it has a positive charge, right? So these two methyl groups will have plus I effect. Because of this plus I effect, they will neutralize this electron deficiency on the nitrogen, and so this will become more stable. Okay, and if this becomes more stable, it will be less acidic. See, if it is very unstable, then it would like to lose that proton. If this species is very unstable, it would like to lose that proton. And acidity is what? The ability to easily donate the proton. So if it is very unstable, it will easily donate the proton and it will become acidic. So the easier it can donate the H plus ion, the more acidic it is. Okay, and if you compare this, you will think that the electron density on this nitrogen is not stabilized, because over here you have two methyl groups which are showing plus I effect, but over here you do not have any methyl groups. So this nitrogen will be very electron deficient and it will be very unstable. But because of the steric hindrance, again this dimethyl anilinium ion becomes more unstable. Okay, the conjugate acid is more unstable, right? So this becomes more unstable. The same concept applies. So because this becomes more unstable, it will more likely lose this proton. I mean, it will more efficiently lose the proton. Since it is going to lose the proton more efficiently than the anilinium ion, it will become acidic. And the acidic, now this is a tricky question, and this is how they are going to frame. Even though this is a fundamental concept of 12th class, yet they can frame it in such a way that it can become a question of a bachelor's level or a master's level entrance exam. Now they will say, now this becomes more acidic. Now the more acidic the compound, the lower the pKa. This is very important. Okay, the more acidic the compound, the lower the pKa value. So because this is more acidic, so it will have a lower pKa. So the pKa of dimethyl anilinium ion will be lesser than pKa of anilinium ion. pKa of this is lesser than pKa of this, because this is more acidic because of steric inhibition of protonation. Okay, so this is a very simple concept. Similarly, you can take one more example. This was the whole concept. Like if we have pyridine. If we have pyridine, right? And on the other hand, we have tertiary butyl groups on both the sides. Now we have tertiary butyl groups on both the sides. So these tertiary butyl groups are again very bulky. So this will make this pyridine less basic, because it will not undergo protonation because of the steric inhibition of protonation. And this pyridine will become more basic than the pyridine with the two tertiary butyl groups. As simple as that. So this is the whole concept of steric inhibition of protonation, which is also known as the SIP. Okay, right.